زواجكم مبارك مبارك زواجكم مبارك مبارك النكاح من سنتي ما قال النبي هو الصحيح نكاح مبارك مبارك نكاح مبارك مبارك زواج مبارك مبارك النكاح من سنتي.
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته my dear brothers and sisters in Islam and welcome to a brand new episode of Happily Ever After. It's an honor and pleasure to have you here and in this pleasure inshallah in this series we will cover quite a few things. We will take a couple through a whole life stage and hopefully this will be a life-changing experience. So we'll talk a proactive and a reactive just in case you're already married. So the singles out there, we'll tell you exactly what you're supposed to be looking for in a spouse, how to handle differences, what happens if, and what happens to you, and what do you say before I do. And the stages of marriage, the engagement and the engagement rules, and how to have discussions about any differences and how to handle them based on solutions, inshallah. And after this, the art of differences, how to turn a negative into a positive, knowing that we are both different breeds. So we'll find out some of the six secrets that are difference between us, how to actually listen to capitalize on our side to make sure that we have a beautiful home, a home sweet home. After this, how to handle marriage differences and how to handle ourselves when we have children and how to keep that drive alive. And indeed, for the ever after, how to have this strong bond between us so we can be happy in this life and hereafter. In this episode, inshallah, we'll be talking about the art of choosing the spouse. And indeed, it is an art. And when I have the children coming in after that, what would be their rights before even thinking about getting married? Keeping that in mind, please note that the first right for your children is choosing the righteous spouse. Believe it or not, is according to the hadith, that if you have a child, they will ask you on Judgment Day. And the hadith says, he hasn't chosen a spouse for me or a mother for me to be befitting in the way that it is supposed to be according to the Quran and Sunnah. So in these episodes, inshallah, we'll talk about the Quran and Sunnah and also the experts in the field. In that research that shows, we will talk about the important opinions of the scholars, the difference of opinions, and we will talk about the gloves are off. So we'll discuss some issues freely with keeping it professional, inshallah, and family atmosphere. So let us start. When a couple comes to my office, and I've been doing counseling for over 20 years, we will learn from this experience, inshallah, they come and complain about their spouse. Well, he does this, he doesn't do that, or my wife does this, or my wife doesn't do that. So the first question I usually ask him, based on what akhi and ukhti, did you actually say yes to this man, or yes to this woman? Since it is ladies first, so we'll talk to the sisters first, what to look for in a husband. And I understand that most of us have certain criterias, and some background or fantasies even we grew up having in back in the mind that we're saying, you know, I want a guy that looks like this. I want a girl that looks like this. With the criteria that we actually get in trouble with because we have a preconceived ideas what a righteous spouse is or a righteous husband in that matter that we were talking to the sisters first. But before I go into the characteristics of what to look for in a spouse, let's find out why we should get married. In sales, they tell you that futures attracts and benefits sell. So let us talk to you, trying to get you the idea of you being married is the most important idea that you will do in this life. Especially in the fitan that we live amongst in these days, in the West or the East, it is now a small world. So no matter where you are, you will need to get married, inshallah. This poor slave of Allah is the advocate of getting early marriage. For the simple fact is, the longer you stay, the more difficult it is. So first out, when I talk to the youth, akhi and ukhti, my dear brothers and sisters, why did you marry or why do you want to get married? They usually come up with the answer, isn't this the right thing to do? Aren't we supposed to get married? Or my mother told me to do so. All that is fine and dandy. We accept. But let's find out more, inshallah, from the Quran and Sunnah so we can turn our adah into ibadah, an act of just the life affairs into an act of worship by the simple fact that we can change our intention. By changing our intention, we get multi rewards. So let's find out what the Quran and Sunnah says about marriage. And we're going to go into details later, inshallah, including rights and duties. So Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ula says, وَأَنْكِحُوا الْأَيَامَ مِنْكُمْ وَالصَّالِحِينَ So we have a command from Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ula says, marry the single amongst you or the unwed amongst you and the righteous. So our intention, not just to get married, our intention is to please Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ula and follow His command. And then we also follow the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because it says, النكاح من سنتي فمن رغب عن سنتي فليس مني. The marriage is from my teaching, is my way. And those who stay away from my teaching is not of me. That's two so far. What else is there? Let's go back to the Quran. You'll find out Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ula said, وَقَدِّمُوا لِأَنفُسِكُمْ. Proceed for thyself. Which means this is the children, according to interpretations among the scholars of the Quran, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala proceed for your children in the heavens, of course. And let's go back to the hadith. You'll find out the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا مَاتَ الْإِنسَانِ إِنْقَطَعْ عَمَلُهُ إِلَّا مِنْ ثَلَاثٍ. If a human being dies, their actions and deeds are cut off except of three. Help me out. Do you remember what the three is? About what we're talking about now is وَلَدٌ صَالِحْ يَدْعُ لَهُ. Of course, the first one is صَدَقَةٌ جَارِيَةٌ, is ongoing charity, عِلْمٌ يَنْتَفَعُ بِهِ. And you'll find out that all the three is in one, beneficial knowledge and the righteous child that will make dua for them. So it's amazing when you'll find out that everything that is in the hadith is actually included in the three. So sadaqatun jariyah, it is true, your child is a sadaqa jariyah. And it's that one of them is, you'll find out that is the best money you spend. According to the hadith, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, the money you spend for the sake of Allah, the money you spend for this and the long list. And he says the best money you spend is the money for your family. So our intention is changing now. For the simple fact is that the second portion of this hadith, that it says, وَعِلْمٌ يُنْتَفَعُ بِهِ, beneficial knowledge. And that means everything you teach your children, you will get till judgment day. So whatever you teach your child, how to pray, how to do certain things in aspect of worship, the matter, the moral conduct, everything you teach him will become on your right-hand side on judgment day. And whatever they teach on going on, you will get the reward. So that's the intention. And وَلَدٌ صَالِحْ يَدْعُو لَهُ, a righteous child. كُلُّ مَوْلُودٌ وَلَدٌ. By the way, most of the people think walad is a boy. Not the case. Linguistically, كُلُّ مَوْلُودٌ وَلَدٌ, every child that is born is walad. It's not a boy or a girl. Now, when they do a dua for you, you will get that. And we need it, my brothers and sisters, especially after we go on. This is why some of the scholars says, even then, as righteous child, we make dua for our parents in every salah. So some of the things that we're going to do in these episodes, we're going to ask you for one thing. I'm going to ask you for change, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. For the simple fact is that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decrees a matter, and when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam decrees a matter, if you go back to the ayah, you'll find out that Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ula says, if it's not befitting for a true believing men and true believing women, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decrees a matter and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam decrees a matter, that we will have a choice of our own. So we submit, we say sami'na wa ata'na. In that case, we will continue inshallah of why we should be getting married. Most of the scholars will tell you, even intimate relations is rewarded. It's amazing. Because the hadith says, a man came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, أَيَأْتِي أَحْدَنَا شَهْوَةً. Meaning, we come, we have this beautiful relationship, the intimacy between spouses. And we get rewarded for all of this? He says, yes. He says, how come? He says, أَرَأَيْتَ, have you not seen, if you actually have that same act in illegitimate relations, meaning outside of marriage, will you not be disciplined for it? He says, of course. He says, similarly, when you have it in the marriage relationships, you will be rewarded for it. So when we do this, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we have to understand that I'm also completing half of my deen. And completing the sister's half of her deen, helping myself lower my gaze, helping her to lower her gaze, protecting ourselves, and you'll see the evidence in the Quran and Sunnah. So you'll find out now, why are we completing the half of deen? We'll go back and find out the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, guarantee two things for me and I will guarantee you Jannah, subhanAllah. And what better thing that you want out of Jannah? We spend our whole life to stay away from hellfire and go to Jannah. So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made it easy for you. At least 50% there. He says, guarantee me two things. What is between your jaws and what is between your legs, I will guarantee you Jannah. Of course, between the jaws, meaning your tongue. It is not our episode, so we can talk about it maybe some other time, inshallah. But he said, and guarantee me and protect what's between your legs, meaning your chastity, your private parts, I will guarantee you Jannah. And that's why the scholars will actually tell you, if you get married, there's 50% there. Because the hadith says two things and that's half of them. So indeed, our intention is to make sure that we are getting the reward for everything we do. So if once you look at the bigger picture, you'll find out that marriage is all about good. So we should not be scared of it. We should be doing so. So why is it that we're looking for it? Well, the choice is yours. You can either get married or fast. Why am I saying this? Because Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, Ya ma'ashar al-shabab. And by the way, if you look into this hadith, you'll find out that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is talking to the youth in the ummah, not the elder, with all due respect to the elder. But he says, Ya ma'ashar al-shabab. Those who actually can afford to get married, فَلْيَتَزَوَّجْ. If you look into this word, you'll find out there are two letters that actually have a lot of meaning. Fa is called fa al-ta'qib. If you study ulum al-Quran and shari'i, may Allah increase our knowledge and give us taqwa and sincerity and accept from all of us, ameen. You'll find out that letter fa actually means ta'qib. Fa al-ta'qib, meaning rush, haste, do not procrastinate. And the lam, if it goes into a fi'l mudara, which means in the present tense, tufid al-talab wal-amr. It's an indication of a command and a request. That means if you have what it takes to get married, do not procrastinate. According to this hadith, it is a command verb. Fa meaning right away, lam meaning have to, and it's a request. So I can please Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ula, so I can be happily ever after, as these episodes will mean, and hopefully you will be happy in this life and happy in the hereafter. I ask Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ula to make us among those who follow this, listen to follow the best of it. Jazakumullah anna khaira. We will see you inshallah after a short break. Thank you for being with us.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I'm Abdurrahim McCarthy, and I would like to wish all of the viewers of Peace TV a blessed Ramadan. May Allah make us from the successful in our fasting and in our prayers.
Say He is Allah one and only. Allah the absolute and eternal. He begets not, nor is He begotten. There is nothing like Him.
Focus on the source of wisdom.
The Quran is a magnet and the Sunnah is a revelation.
Islam had the solution right from the beginning. We apply that and the problem is solved.
Focus on the solution for our world.
There is no man on the face of earth. His life was narrated to us like Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Poor, rich, white, black, Arab, non-Arab, everybody say the same word. Obey Allah, obey the messenger.
Focus on the Akhirah.
Tawbah is mandatory upon each and every Muslim.
Success for the Muslim is having the correct belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Allah has power over all things.
Focus on the facts and realities that motivate the world towards Islam. In Islam in Focus, every Monday to Saturday at 5 p.m. and repeat telecast at 5 a.m. India on Peace TV.
Where truth is hidden, misleading quotations create confusion. Where truth is hidden, lack of knowledge and wisdom cause upheaval and commotion. Where truth is hidden, manipulated scriptures and twisted facts emerge. This very hidden truth creates false propaganda, mayhem, chaos, disorder, and turmoil in our lives and the world order. But is there anyone with courage and wisdom? What is the truth? And who has the courage to expose it? Because it's your right to know the truth.
Watch Truth Prevail and Lies Perish in Truth Exposed by Dr. Zakir Naik, next on Peace TV.
Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulullah. Amma ba'd, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, and welcome back to the second half of this first episode of the series, Happily Ever After. And we were talking about the art of choosing the spouse. And indeed, it is an art, as we mentioned before in the first episode. We were just scratching the surface, because indeed, this is the most important thing in your marriage. If you choose right, you don't have to worry about the rest of your life. But of course, we don't make the mistake, as most of the brothers think, that as soon as I find a righteous wife, I'm done, as if she's angelized. Please keep in mind, my dear brother and sister Islam, that we are human beings. We make mistakes and sin. According to the hadith, the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ says, "Kull bani Adam khata." In that case, every human being makes a sin and mistakes, and the best of those who make sins and mistakes, al-khata'un, those who tawwabun, those who repent and come back to Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ula. If that's the case, we have now laid the foundation why we should get married and the benefits of it, not just because it's the right thing to do or my mother told me to do so and whatever that may be. So now let's talk to the sisters first. My dear sisters in Islam, on what basis are you going to say yes to this man? Is it because of the ring that he's given you? Is it because he's actually driven in with a Mercedes-Benz? Or the way he looks and the hair that flies in the air? Or the way he does his tie? Of course it is. Or he's a doctor or an engineer. What else is there? Of course, we'll talk about the aspects, what we call 4x4. Now, the first thing, my dear sister in Islam, please understand that you have the right. Believe it or not, the puck stops with you. The brother comes to ask for your hand in marriage, but it is you who say yes or no. So really, if anything happens, when the sister comes to complain at my in my office to talk about this brother that has not done his rights or the duties in that matter, so say, "Ukhti, why did you choose this brother? How could you say yes to this man?" Don't mean to make him feel bad, wallahi, but at least I'm trying to save some of the sisters, that it's not too late for some of you. And don't give up yet, don't worry. And the later on of these episodes, we will also tell you how to get out of these things, and that's why I always ask for change. So please make sure our intention is to change. We're going to take the pride and the arrogance out, not the dignity, but I understand that when you say this, the idea behind I am right and you're wrong, we should be tossing that out the door. Because now Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ilaha, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is going to take us on this roadmap of what to do and what not to do. Speaking of the Quran and Sunnah, let's find out that Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ilaha is telling you two things, ukhti. Two criterias in the Quran is mentioned, and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is giving you two criterias in the Sunnah. You know what they are? It's not a private jet and a Swiss bank account. It's in the richest and the strongest and all of that stuff. It is included, but indeed it's not the criteria. So let's find out. Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ula, speaking of that, who is talking about it? This is the one that married Musa alayhi salam, the daughter of Shu'aib. He says, "Ya abad ista'jir, inna khayra man ista'jart, al-qawi, al-ameen." These are the first two characters that you look for in a husband. Before I go further, please understand, my dear brothers out there, when I talk to the sisters asking her to look for a spouse, I am actually talking to you indirectly, which means I want you to acquire these characters that I'm asking the sisters to look for. So when Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ula says the two important characters in the Quran is what to look for, qarang, ameen meaning trustworthy. I'm going to have to come back and explain that and why they are together. And then Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is giving you two other criterias. He says, "In ja'akum man tardahu khuluqu wa deenu." Khuluq and deen. So you see they rhyme. Qawi, ameen, khuluq and deen. So for you to remember them, easy for you, inshallah, sisters. Which means, if someone comes to ask for your daughter's hand in marriage, he has to have two characters. Khuluq, moral conduct, and a behavior, ethics, character. And deen, religious background. This fankihu, again, the letter fa comes in right away. Fankihu, this is a command verb again. Marry them. Illam taf'alu, it's conditional now. And if you don't, meaning if you don't marry those who have the khuluq and deen, the character and the religious background, تَكُنْ فِتْنَةٌ وَفَسَادٌ فِي الْأَرْضُ مُبِينٌ, or كَبِيرٌ, another hadith. He says, it will be transgression and mischief on the face of the earth. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, let us fear Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ula in choosing the spouse. Now I am talking to the guardians, my brothers and sisters. Please make sure you make it easy for your daughters and your sons to get married. You know why? Because if we make what is halal to be difficult, haram will be easy. We're not given the green light, wallahi. If it's difficult for me to get married now, I'm going to do whatever it takes. That's not the case. We said that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, if you don't have what it takes to get married, you are going to fast. فَإِنَّهُ لَهُ وِجَاءٌ. This is a prevention, a way to actually protect yourself. So let's go to the 212 and find out why they are there. So my dear sister, I hope you're listening with your heart, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make you the best wife, ameen, and give you the best husband. So if you protect yourself, Allah will give you someone that protecting himself some too. So let us find out. First of all, At-Tabari rahmatullahi alayh, in the tafsir he says, Al-Qawi, heen, strong in the deen. However, the contemporary scholar says, Qawi in everything. Meaning what? Qawi intellectually, financially, physically, mentally, academically, every aspect of life, emotionally, and so on. So Qawi, I don't mean the brother that the bench is 300 and squats 700. That's not what we mean. We mean Qawi in every aspect of life. Ameen, trustworthy. Now please don't look for a brother called Ameen and says, Alhamdulillah, Shaykh, I found brother Ameen. That's not what we mean. Ameen, trustworthy, ukhti. Why? Because you are going to trust your life with this brother. You see the hadith says, هُنَّ عَوَانٌ عِنْدَكُمْ. They're like asra, they're like hostages. You see, you live with your husband now, ukhti. Allah subhanahu wa jalla fula, give him the qawama. Give him the responsibility and that rank which we'll talk about a little bit later in the series, inshallah. So you follow. In that case, who are you going to trust? To trust whom? With what, ukhti? Trust this man that will be called your husband. To do what? To keep you away from the hellfire and to take you with him to Jannah. So is he going to be Ameen? And why are they together, do you think? You see, if Allah subhanahu wa jalla fila puts them together, there must be a reason. Qawiyyan Ameen. If the brother has the power, qawi, in every aspect, but he doesn't have the amana, trustworthiness, he may misuse or abuse his power. That's not a very good combination. And that's the reason the scholars will tell you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran mentioned qawi and ameen, strong and trustworthy. Now, my dear sister, in this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is trying to tell you something. You have the right, ukhti, to ask your father to help you to get married. My dear brothers, as fathers, it is your responsibility to look for a suitable suitor for your daughter. Indeed it is. Please, let us find out the difference between culture and religion and make sure that our Creator becomes before our creation. I'm not going to talk politics here, but I'm only going to talk Quran and Sunnah. Please do not be offended. I don't know who you are. I don't know what your culture is. But we're going to say something called mafhum al-khilaf, knowledge of the opposite, which means what? If we say that this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, and that's what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to do in the Sunnah, the opposite of that is not acceptable. In the bigger picture, of course, not in specific, in the details, but that's what we are going to say. So we have to make sure that we understand what urf is about. So I'm laying the foundation in these series in the first episode. So please bear with me to make sure that we have the right intention and the right frame of mind to be able to be happy in this life and happily ever after. So when do we take the urf? What is the urf? Urf is ma ta'arafu alayhi an-nas fi salah, what is good. Meaning what people accept from one another, living among one another, to know that is acceptable and it is to be good and righteous. So we do accept urf. Islam does accept urf, akhi and ukhti. But when? مَا لَمْ يُخَالِفْ نَصٌ صَرِيحٌ أَوْ حَدِيثٌ صَحِيحٌ, which means, as long as it does not contradict, we're clear verse, meaning there is no room for interpretation, or hadith that is sahih, that is authentic prophetic tradition. So if that's the case, we will take the ayah and the hadith before the urf. If it does not contradict, we default to the urf. So we accept, inshallah. So if that's the case, we say قَوِيٌ أَمِينٌ is the first one, and we have learned from this ayah that your father has the ability and has the power to look for one, as this poor slave of Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ala had done with my own daughters. I do look and I declared it. I do check, even in the masajid that I go to. I keep an eye out for a righteous son-in-law, inshallah, because it is more important to me to make sure that my daughter is looked after. The son, may Allah bless him, they are in a different field on their own. We'll talk about that in the second episode, inshallah. But in that case, what are we looking for, ukhti? Allah subhanahu wa jalla fiyullah has given you also the green light to do so. Let me give you the proof of what I just said. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu an as-sahaba di ajma'in. May Allah be pleased with all of them. Ameen. Didn't he not look for a husband for his own daughter, Hafsa radiyallahu anha wa an ummatul minina ajma'in? Did he not go to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Did he not go to Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu? Uthman ibn Affan radiyallahu anhu? Was he not upset because they did not want to marry? But you know why they did not want to marry? Because, of course, they knew the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was going to marry, but they did not want to divulge the secret. So when he went to Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, he was silent. He didn't say anything. When he went to Uthman, you know, he says, give me a little bit of time. But when he went to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he smiled. He says, don't be upset, because your daughter will marry someone better than them, and they will marry someone better than your daughter. And of course, what that meant was Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was going to marry Hafsa radiallahu anha wa anhumat majma'in. Now the other side of that, ukhti, was in the hadith, إِذَّا جَاءَكُمْ مَنْ تَرْضَوْنَ خُلُقُ وَدِينَ سُوْ خُلُقَ النِّينَ قَوِيٌّ أَمِينَ خُلُقَ النِّينَ. Just for you to remember them in rhyme. The character and the moral conduct of the brother and the religious background of the brother, of course. Please understand, ukhti, that the character, which we'll talk about in details in the next episode, inshallah, because the time is running out, and the religious background, they actually correlate. And I'm going to explain that why. But let me first explain in the few minutes that we have in this episode, the moral conduct. Why, ukhti? Because you are an emotional back. In that case, please understand that we'll talk about six secrets later on between the difference between men and women. Inshallah, we will continue on the next episode, asking Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ula to make us among those who listen to speech and follow the best of it. Ameen. Wa akhir da'wan alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa sallam ala alihi wa sahbihi wa tabi'een. I thank you for being part of this family, and hopefully we can all be happily ever after. Jazakumullah anna khayra. We will see you in the next episode, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. From this day